Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up Home Assistant on a Proxmox virtual machine. A virtual machine is one of the best ways to self-host Home Assistant, especially when you don't have access or aren't using an officially supported operating system or device like the Raspberry Pi. The reason for this is that the virtual machine comes with everything pre-configured in a way that makes it easier to use Home Assistant. For this tutorial, you will need to have Proxmox already installed to a machine. We will link to some guides on how you can do this below. With the Proxmox web interface open, the first thing we'll want to do is select the host device that you plan on running Home Assistant on. For this example, we are using our Raspberry Pi. Once selected, click the Create VM button in the top right corner of the screen. The first thing you want to do is make a note of the VM ID. You'll need this value later on in the guide. Next, set a name for this virtual machine. We recommend using HAOS as the name. Once set, click the Next button. Since we will be importing the Home Assistant virtual machine image, click the Do Not Use Any Media option and then click the Next button. Now click the BIOS select box and then select the third option labeled OVMF space UEFI. With that selected, we now need to select the EFI storage by clicking the select box and then clicking a valid storage location. In our case, we are using our local directory. Make a note of the name of the storage you selected as we will need this later on in the guide. You will then need to untick the pre-enroll keys checkbox and then click the next button to continue. As we are importing our own disk, we will want to delete the one that is set up by default by clicking the delete button next to it. Once done, click the next button. You can now control the amount of CPU cores that your Home Assistant virtual machine will have access to through Proxmox. We recommend at least setting 2. Once set, click the next button to continue. You can now control the amount of memory that the Home Assistant virtual machine will have access to. As a bare minimum, we recommend at least 4 GB or 4096 megabytes. After setting this, click the next button. You'll now be taken to the network tab. Most of the default options should work fine, so just click the next button to continue. This final screen gives you an overview of all your settings for your new virtual machine. If everything looks correct, click the Finish button. With the virtual machine now created, we can move on to installing Home Assistant onto it. To do this, open up the shell by clicking the Shell button in the top right corner of your screen. Now that we have access to the shell on your host system, we can move on to setting up Home Assistant. Our first step is to create a directory where we will store the image that we are about to download. Create this directory by typing in mkdir space -p space /var/lib/vz/template/qcow and then press enter. After creating the directory, change into it by typing in cd /var/lib/vz/template/qcow. This next step will differ slightly depending if you are running an ARM system or just a normal x64 system. For those running an x64 based system, type in www.space/var/lib/vz/template/qcow/13.2/haos_ova-13.2.qcow2.xz/hyphen /capital O/HAOS.QCOW2.xz. Now, if you're running an x64 system, you can now press enter and then skip the next step. However, if you're running an ARM-based system like a Raspberry Pi, for example, this command would differ as we need to use a different virtual machine. So delete back until you just get to the HAOS underline. And then type in generic hyphen arch 64 hyphen 13.2.qcow2.xz space hyphen capital O, space HAOS dot QCAL 2.exe and then press enter. Wget will now download the Home Assistant image that we will use to get it up and running on your Proxmox virtual machine. Once the image is downloaded, we need to extract it by typing in UNXZ space HAOS dot QCOW 2.exe. Depending on your machine, this may take a minute or two to extract. Once the extraction is completed, we can now import the Home Assistant image into Proxmox by typing in QM space import disk space, followed by your virtual machine ID, which in our case is 100, followed by space slash var slash lib slash vz slash template slash qcout slash haos.qcow2, followed by a space and then the name of the storage device that you set earlier, which in our case is local. The Home Assistant virtual machine image will now be imported into Proxmox. Once done, click the X button and close out of the shell. With the Home Assistant image now imported, we need to get our Proxmox virtual machine to actually use it. Use the left hand sidebar to select your virtual machine. Once selected, change to the hardware window using the sidebar. Now on this screen, select the option labeled unused disk and then click the edit button. On this screen, all you'll want to do is enable the discard option and then click the add button. With the Home Assistant virtual machine image now loaded in by Proxmox, we now need to correct the boot order to ensure it boots from this new disk. To do this, change to the options menu and then click the boot order option and then click edit. On this screen, untick the first two options and tick the one labeled SCSI0. Once set, click OK to continue. All we need to do now is click the start button to get Home Assistant booting within our Proxmox virtual machine. You can watch your Home Assistant virtual machine boot up by changing to the console screen. It may take a few minutes for Home Assistant to fully start on your machine. If everything has worked properly, you should now see the Home Assistant logo displayed within the console, as well as the IP addresses that have been assigned to your virtual machine. Make a note of the IPv4 local IP address, as this is what you will use to access Home Assistant through your web browser. At this point, you have successfully got Home Assistant up and running within a Proxmox virtual machine. Our next few steps will just walk you through the initial setup process of Home Assistant. Now, open your favorite web browser and go to http://, followed by the IP address you saw within the Proxmox console, followed by a colon symbol and then the port 8123. The first time you access the Home Assistant web interface, you might be greeted with a preparing Home Assistant screen. Just wait a little bit and it will soon switch over to the initial setup experience. Begin setting up Home Assistant by clicking the Create My Smart Home button. Set a name and username as well as a password for your admin Home Assistant account. Ensure you set a secure password, as this user will have full rights to your Home Assistant installation. Once done, click the Create Account button. This next screen allows you to set your home location. This is used for weather data as well as proximity-based automations. In our case, we are setting ours to Hobart, Australia. Once set, click the Next button to continue. You'll now have a chance to enable or disable any of Home Assistant's internal analytics tools. These tools are used to help the Home Assistant developers improve the software. You'll now see a list of compatible devices that Home Assistant has automatically detected on your network. To finish setting up Home Assistant, click the Finish button. You have now successfully set up Home Assistant within a Proxmox VM and gone through its basic configuration steps. You can now begin to use this software to automate things around your house. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.